Question number 14 deals with what? A pulley arrangement, roof, and you have a pulley attached with the same. Over this pulley, you have a rope, a string, and you have two masses, M1 and M2. Let me say M1 is say 4 kg, M2 is a relatively smaller one, 3 kg. In your opinion, which mass will move down? M1. M1 is more, M2 is less, that is why M1 will move down, M2 will move upward. So, when you release it, it will move downward with acceleration magnitude only, A. What is the magnitude of first, same is the magnitude of the second also. Why? Because if M1 comes down by 1 meter, M2 moves up by 1 meter. Magnitude, I repeat, magnitude of the acceleration remains the same, but acceleration is not same. Why? Yes? Direction. This mass is moving downwards. This mass is moving upward. So, magnitude of acceleration of M1 and M2 is same. But, direction is different. Now, throughout the string there is a tension. So, we mark the tension T, which tries to keep the mass upward. Here also the tension tries to keep the mass upwards. The two weights will have downward force acting on the pulley. That is why tension here is downwards, tension here is also downwards. Tension at this point is upward, T dash, and this support, the whole mass will try to move the support down. That is where tension at this point, T dash, is downwards. Notes Bandhgal. 2 minutes, one full page. Rather 2 pages. I will suggest 2 pages. You write on the left. Draw the diagram. Purpose of the article is to find acceleration A, tension T. That is what we want to find out. Let us redefine this. Mass M1 is say 4 kg, M2 is say 3 kg. M1 will move down, M2 will move up, because M1 is more than M2. Tension throughout the string is T. This tension tries to keep this mass upwards. Here also it tries to keep it upwards. This tension is downward, and these two taken together try to make the system move down. So, step 1. For mass M1, downward force acting is what? Yes, M1g. Downward force acting is M1g. We draw the free body diagram for this mass only. That is, M1g is downwards, tension T is upward, and acceleration A is downwards. Acceleration is equal to net force divided by mass. Net force acting is equal to what? M1g is more than T. It is moving downwards. M1G is say 40, this is say 20, then the net force acting is downwards. So M1G minus T divided by M1, this is A, one equation. For step 2, for mass M2, yes, T is more than M2G. It is moving upwards. T has to be more than M2G. So, without writing this one, you can say T is more, M2G is less, and it is having acceleration A in upward direction. I will just write the result. A is equal to, yes, yes, T minus M2G divided by M2. This is equation number 2. 3 minutes with you to write it. 3 minutes to write. What is the purpose? What do you want to find out? Acceleration A and tension T. Now, equation number 1, A is not known, M1 is given, say 4 kg, M1 is given, say 4 kg, G is 9.8 or 10, T is not given, T is unknown. How many unknowns are there? A and T. Second equation, again A and T are unknown. How many equations do you have? 2 equations and 2 unknown. Can we find out? Compare the 2, step 3. Step 3, magnitude of acceleration in both the cases is same. Magnitude of acceleration is equal to M1G minus T over M1. It is also equal to T minus M2G over M2. From this one, yes, from this equation, M1 is known, G is known, M1 is known, T is unknown, T is unknown, M2 known, G known, M2 known. Find T. Solve and find value of T. What you get is, if you multiply, cross multiply, M1, M2, G, you try independently please. Without having a look on the board, try independently. M1, M2, G, when you shift it to the other side, it is 2, M1, M2, G. What you want to find out is T. T is equal to 2. M1, M2 over M1 plus M2 into G, sorry. How many of you got the answer? Everything is same, only one unknown, T. Practice. 9th rather 7th class question. Only one unknown, T. Shift this T to the other side. So, what do you get? T, M1 plus M2. T is equal to this. Step 4. So, what you get is, step 3, tension is equal to, you have answered it. Result is, yes, 2M1, M2 over M1 plus M2 into G. Step 4, any one equation, step 4, you can use this part A, is equal to m1 g minus t over m1. Put value of t in this equation, because now we want to find out is a. It is 2 m1 m2 g over m1 plus m2 divided by m1. What you get is? Solve and come out with answer. A is equal to. Yes. M1. Result. Only the result. Solve. Only result. You have m1 in the denominator also. m1 is cancelled. This m1 is also cancelled. Result is m1 minus m2 divided by m1 plus m2 times g. So, the conclusion is tension is equal to the given value and acceleration A is equal to m1 minus m2 over m1 plus m2 into g. Any idea about T dash? This pulley is not moving upward or downwards. This pulley is at rest, net force acting is 0. So, in case you need in any of the objective questions, T dash is equal to 2 times T. Upward force T dash, downward force is T and T. The object is at rest. Net force is 0. Downward force T and T. Net downward force is 2T. Upward force is T dash. Upward force is equal to downward force. So, T dash is equal to what? 2T. So, conclusion is what? Acceleration is equal to, yes, m1 minus m2 divided by m1 plus m2 into g, and tension is equal to what? Tension is equal to 2 m1 m2 divided by m1 plus m2 g. Now, we try with the numerical number 27. Numerical number 27. Question is, two bodies of masses 4 kg and 3 kg respectively are connected by a light string passing over smooth frictionless pulley. Calculate acceleration of masses and tension in the string. M1 is, yes, given. M1 is equal to 4 kg. M2 is equal to what? 3 kg. What you have to find out is acceleration A, tension T. A part. Acceleration is equal to m1 minus m2 over m1 plus m2 into g. Yes, m1 is equal to 4 kg minus m2 is equal to 3 kg divided by m1 is 4, m2 is 3, g is, let me say, 10. Solve and come out with the answer, please. Solve and come out with an answer. 10 by 7, am I right? 10 by 7, just work out this. 10 by 7 is equal to what? 1.4. Then 1.4. meter per second square. If you put 9.8, the answer is different, right? This is first part. What about second part? Yes, A is equal to, as per this formula, you have answered. What about this T, tension in the string? Tension in the string T is equal to 2 m1 m2 over m1 plus m2 into g is equal to 2 m1 4 m2 3 4 plus 3 g is equal to 10. Solve and come out with the answer. Yes? 34.2. What units? Tension means force. Tension means force. 34.2. So again, it is a result for the same. Now, try question number 28. Draw the diagram. Numerical number 28. We term this a tractor trolley arrangement. It is two objects on a frictionless floor. It is not a pulley arrangement. One mass M1. As per theory, this is mass M1. What is the value of M1? 50 kg. Another mass M2, yes, 150 kg. The two are connected by a string. And you have applied a force, how much? You have to find out? You have to find out the force. What else is given? Acceleration. Both the masses are moving with acceleration A equal to how much? 5 meter per second square. So what is given? Given M1 50 kg, M2 150 kg, acceleration A 5 meter per second square. What you have to find out is force required. Let us make it a practical problem. How? See, there is a tractor. All of you have seen a tractor. And a trolley. Big trolley attached is the same. We term this as a tractor trolley arrangement. Where is the engine? Yes, here in the tractor. So tractor will develop a force F. This trolley tries to slow down. This trolley will try to slow down the tractor. That means trolley tries to apply a force in opposite direction here, tension T. What about the tractor? Tractor tries to accelerate the trolley. That is why tension here is towards right. That is the reason for this direction of a tension. Tension is nothing but a force. Trolley applies a force on the tractor in backward direction. It tries to slow down. And the tractor tries to move the trolley, accelerate the trolley in the forward direction. That is why it is T1. The two are having same acceleration. So, step 1. Analyze this tractor only. Free body diagram. We term this as a free body diagram. What is the forward force? F. Backward force? T. Which of the two is more? F or T? F. Because acceleration is in the forward direction. Then and only then tractor will move in the forward direction. That is why acceleration is A. Mass of the object is M1. A. Acceleration is equal to net force. Forward force F minus backward force T. Net force is F minus T divided by M1. One equation. Wait. Try to understand. Step 2. Trolley. Yes. How many forces are acting? Only one. Horizontal direction, only one force is acting. And it is having what acceleration? A. So for this, A is equal to net force T divided by mass of the trolley M2. So now you have two equations. One, two. Step 3. You have two equations. You can eliminate T from the two. Agreed? So, acceleration is given. A is how much? 5. A is 5. M1 is given how much? 50. M2 is given how much? How many unknown are there? How many values or parameters you don't know? F and T are known. That is why I will rewrite. You can say these equations. And I will write A is equal to what? 5. Let me write this as step 3. Not an issue. 5 is equal to F, I don't know. T, I don't know. Divided by mass. How much? 50 kg. One equation. And second one, A, 5, tension, I don't know, divided by mass, 150. Now you have how many equations? 2. How many unknown? From this second one, T is equal to how much? Yes. On solving this, what you get is T is 750 Newton. 1. What about A? A is equal to what? See, no, not A, F. The second unknown is F. So, in this equation, 550, F, T is not now known to you. How much? 750. So, if you put T is equal to 750, then F is equal to what? 5 into 50, 250. This is 750. When you take to the other side, what you get is F is equal to 1000. 2 minutes with you to complete. Tractor trolley arrangement.